Okay, students, we will wait for 1 minute, then we'll start.
So can we start?
1 minute, just 1 minute. Okay, now who has not joined? Yes, students, just one minute, please. Okay, fine. Now we are going to start our quiz. All set, ready? So today is the new chapter, that is matter around us pure. Let's see what you are going to get in this paper. Your first question is in front of you. Grams of common salt is dissolved in 320 grams of water. The mass percentage of salt is. Read the question carefully, then do it. Very easy question, but yes, very easy. Do it. Get the full marks. I'm expecting 100%. You know, I've not seen a curve in which, like, I have not seen any graph in which there are rest other bars are zero and the one bar is showing 100%. I have never seen that thing. So, can you show that in today's center mark? Oh, but in chemistry it didn't happen in chemistry, I think. So,
sir,
let's see. Yes, tell me.
Sir, this wasn't this. No, sir. I'll tell.
Okay.
Yes, sir. Now I. Sir, now I'll tell. This question was there in the textbook, right?
I don't know. Okay, fine. So, wherever. Yes, what happened?
Sir, it is in the textbook, this question.
Okay, I don't know from if it is there in the textbook or not, but I got it from, like, I have so. So from source I got. Okay, fine, no problem. Let's go. So still 25, more than 50% of you have done this question wrong. It's very easy. So just I'll take you 1 minute to explain this. Okay, not much. Just 1 minute. So it is. See. Okay. First question is in front of you. So question says that. If you read the question, it is like percentage mass by mass they ask. What is the percentage of the solution? The salt is given to you. That is the 1 minute. 40 gram is given to you and it's 100 gram of the solution. Just a minute, students. Just 1 minute. Guys, listen. Okay, please, mute your mics.
That's why you should spend time on the question.
Okay, so 40, okay, I'll explain after this. Okay, don't worry. 1 minute, I'll explain this question. Just go to the next one, then we'll see. Okay, first see the result. What is the leaderboard says? Okay. So the leaderboard is saying that Rishabh NPS INR is leading, I think. Okay, fastest. Jayant and Rishabh both have done at the same speed. Okay, fine. We'll discuss that just after the next question. Okay, are you ready, all of you? We'll discuss that question, don't worry. Yes, coming to the next question, it says the mixture of sulfur and carbon disulfide is. What? You have to tell the answer in this. Heterogeneous and shows Tyndall effect. Homogeneous and shows Tyndall effect. Heterogeneous and does not show Tyndall effect. Homogeneous and does not show Tyndall effect. I hope most of you get it correct. Let's see. Okay, fine, Monisha. Monisha, but I think I explained this. Okay, fine. That is the carbon and carbon disulfide and sulfur. What is going to form? I told you somewhere in the class. Okay, please Monisha, what you are typing? Okay, so the answer is this. Carbon disulfide and sulfur forms a colloidal solution, and colloidal solutions are always heterogeneous. Colloidal solution are heterogeneous but show spindle effect. So answer is A. Very good students. Moving to the next one. So who is learning the C? Okay, so answer is Rohan is leading KRM 9. Very good, Rohan. Fine. Moving to the next question. The tincture of iodine has an antiseptic property. This solution is made of dissolving. Tincture of iodine. It is also there in NCRT. Those who were saying, sir, it is there in the book or somewhere else. It is also there in the NCRT. Tincture of iodine has an antiseptic property. And, you know, this I also explained in class that you must have seen the tincture of iodine in your medical room. You must have seen that. Oh, time's up. It was just 30 seconds. And it is nothing but iodine and alcohol mixture. Very good. Mixture of iodine and alcohol. Very good, students. Moving to the next question. First, we'll see the leaderboard. I know you people are just waiting for leaderboard to see the leaderboard now. KRM, NPS KRM is leading. Oh, no. RNR NPS is leading. Very good, Nishan. Fastest. Very good. Let's see the next question. The next question is, two substances A and B were made to react to form the third substance. A to B according to the following, 2A plus B gives A to B. Which of the following statements concerning these reactions are incorrect? Product A to B shows the property of substance A and B. The product will always have fixed composition. Product so formed cannot be classified as compound. The product so formed is an element. So, I think 24 have answered as of now. Monisha, please stop forwarding this. Okay, so what is GI? GI, I didn't understand. GIIG. Okay. Okay, so, okay, got it. Well, stop telling two lessons on, okay, fine. Yes, so you have 16 more seconds. You know, A to B, it's forming from A and B. Okay, and the answer of this question is, product A to B shows the property of substance A and B. The product will always have a fixed composition. Oh my god. So it times up. Oh, so 23 students have done this right. Let's see what is this question. Why you people have made mistake in this. So if you open the fourth question, says that the two substances A and B were made to react to form a third substance. Third substance is forming, no problem. And it is nothing, students. A plus B, let's say 2A plus B gives you A to B. A to B is nothing but a compound. And a compound does not have a properties of its elements. So A to B shows the property of substance A and B? No. Shows product will always have a fixed composition? Yes. The product so formed cannot be classified as a compound? No. The product so formed is an element? No. They have asked you incorrect. Write the incorrect. So these three are incorrect. 1, 3 and 4. Answer is C. Hope you understood this. Yes. And again, I'll go to the question number one. Question number one is this. 40 gram of common salt is dissolved. 40 gram of common salt. I will just take your 1 minute. 40 gram of common salt. This is solute. And 320 gram is the water. That is solvent. The mass percent. Percent weight by weight is the mass percent. Is mass of solute. Mass of solute divide by mass of solution. Most of you must have made mistake in this formula. You must have written mass of solvent. So what you are going to write, mass of solute is 40 divided by 360 into 100. This is the answer. Understood? Okay, this is very important. This concept is used in other questions also. That's why I have explained it. If anyone has any doubt, please ask now. Okay, now. So, coming to the next question. So, this is the next question. First, we'll see the leaderboard. Students, I'm eagerly waiting to see that chart, like all are giving right answer in one question. I'm eagerly waiting for that moment. Okay, NPS RN or Nishant is still leading. Nishant, be careful, read the question properly, then answer. Okay, and then now you have next question.
So it's not showing the question.
So what is this?
No, there's no question.
I don't see the question.
What's the answer?
What is the question?
Question.
The question.
So.
No problem.
Show the question
problem.
In the folder.
Okay, fine. Leave it.
Simply mark something.
Okay. No problem. No problem. Don't mark anything. We are moving to the next.
You should just leave the question.
Don't worry. Move to the next question. Why you worry?
So how do people get points?
So oh, they got points. So it's not.
I have just guessed. So it should be a
reason. It should be a reason.
Yeah. You can go back and tell us the right answer.
Okay, fine. See.
By two places.
Okay, moving to the next question. Be ready for that. A student carefully observed the colloidal of starch in water. Human blood and cow milk. On the basis of observation, he made certain conclusion given below. Choose the wrong conclusion about the colloidal solution. Very easy question. Okay, students, question number 5th was very important. I will show you at the end of the quiz. Don't worry. Okay. So, okay, fine. Moving to the answer says that answer of this question is, 14 students have only marked it right. Okay, just let me see. Okay, fine. So let me go to the question. We'll discuss how it happened, how you can solve this. I think it's the question number 6. Okay, moving to the question number 6. First, I'll explain you. Okay, a student carefully observed the colloidal. I think most of you have made mistake because you must have not read this. Choose the wrong conclusion. And you know, all this starch in water, human blood and cow milk, all these are the colloidal solution. Okay?
Sir, B is wrong.
Component or separatory by, okay, no. 1 minute.
Sir, I clicked C and I got the answer right.
Okay, translucent, it is not C. Student, careful.
So you can't filter milk using a filter paper.
1 minute. Components can be separated by ordinary filtration. No. Okay. Homogeneous and stable. Okay. So B and C.
Both are wrong.
Both are wrong.
They should get points.
Okay, fine, fine. We will ignore this question. See, just.
So, but the people will still get the point.
You can go back. So when the leaderboard comes, you press go back 4 times.
Exactly.
Because the previous question was wrong.
Yes, sir.
So you must go back 4 times and tell us the correct option for the previous question. And then we can mark it.
So the go back button.
Okay. Go back then.
So go back 4 times. Because even the previous question was there.
Okay, fine. Wait. I'll explain you the previous question also. Just give me 1 second. Okay, this is the second time. This was the result. This was the third time. This was what you were saying. And this is the fourth one. Yes? Okay. Yes. Now, what do you want to say? Should I move to the next one?
Yes, sir. Now you can start. Then it will start from the start. So, and can you tell the right answer for this question?
Okay, question number 5, right answer you want. Okay, fine. I'll tell you. Question number 5, right answer
is... B, right?
Yes. 1 minute. I'll show you. Answer of question number 5 is B. Do it. But I will explain you. That is a very important question. B for Bombay. B. Okay, mark it B. Just a minute.
Sir, I wasn't able to vote in time.
So you didn't, so you have
sir,
to go back.
So you have to go back and wait.
Okay. Just a minute.
So now go back and then you have to wait.
Okay. But still, this is the previous result, yes? Okay, fine. After that, we have to go to the next step. Okay, just a minute. Now it's over. I'm moving to the next question. All right? Yes.
Yes, sir. We have to mark B, right?
Yes, B.
Sir, but it's already marked.
But it is not possible to vote again because
I'm voting time. Means your name voting.
Okay.
So proceed, sir. It's fine.
Okay, leave it. We move to the next question. Please don't waste time.
Yes, sir.
So what about this? B and C, both our options are right. So I'll make it correct there. Fine. Moving to the next question. Okay, still 31. Okay, 31 have written B. I'll see. Next one is, do this one. So... Okay, so moving to the next question. This is the question. Please read it carefully. Okay, fine. Question reads as, there are 4 test tube ABCD half filled with water, a considerable quantity of sugar, milk, egg, white, and common salt was added in them, respectively, with stirring the contents of each tube. True solution will be contained in which solution? In which of them? Sugar, milk, egg white, and common salt. Okay. So you have to tell me the true solution is present in which of them? So last 5 seconds, and let's see, this time I think all of you will do this right. Oh my god, still you people have made it wrong. True solution will be with the salt and sugar. Okay, so that will be the true solution. But I want to explain you that question number 5, okay, because in next question you may need help from that question number 5. So please solve it now. Do it fast and tell me what is the answer. How to do it, that's the important part. How to do is the important part. Can you solve this question, all of you? Please solve it and tell me the answer. The solubility of solute is 8. Okay, fine, but solve it. Solubility of solute is 8. Okay, and you need to... Density is 1.364. Find the weight by volume percentage. Can you do that? Weight by volume percentage. Okay, I will tell you. Solubility of solute is 8. What do you mean by this? 8 gram of solute.
Wow, something went wrong.
Screen share.
Yeah.
Wow. Sir has left audio. That
sir isn't there.
He's dead. His connection
sir
is
isn't there.
Sir is there.
Sir left audio.
Yeah, well,
dude, two of the questions were wrong, man.
Okay.
I know.
Chill, right? Bro. Chill.
You got it right that side.
Okay, okay, please don't make noise. Okay, see, so.
So we don't see your screen.
I'm sharing, 1 minute, it got disconnected. Yes, now you can see, just a minute. I'm sharing it again.
So can you talk a little louder?
Yes, now. Can you see my screen?
Thank you, you can.
Yes, can you see my screen now? Okay, fine. So I was explaining this question. If you see the solubility of the salt, please mute your mic. If you see the solubility of salt, what is that? 1 minute. If you see the solubility of salt, that is this. Okay, 1 minute. This was the question we were discussing. Okay, so 8 gram of solute can be dissolved in 100 gram. So just assume 100 gram of solvent. Okay, is there 100 gram of solvent is there? This is our assumption. Okay, this is our assumption. Okay, now what you will say? If 100 gram of solvent is there, so mass of solution is 108 gram. Mass of solution is 108 gram. Density is given 1.36. Density is 1.36. Mass of solution you have. Density you have. Density is nothing but 1.364. Implies volume of solution is. Volume is nothing but mass divided by density. 108 divided by 1.364. Here, from here you will get the volume. They asked you find the weight by volume percent. Percentage weight by volume. All of you know that. Mass of solute divided by volume of solution. This is the percentage weight by volume. This is the concentration term into 100. Mass of solute, volume of solution into 100. This is percentage weight by volume. Volume of solution you can get from this equation. Let's say this is X. Mass of solute is 8. So percentage weight by volume is 8 by X into 100. You will be going to get 10. I'm saying that why I have explained this. This question will be helpful in solving one question, which will come afterwards. So if you have any doubt, please ask. Any doubt? No? This is the percentage weight by volume. Mass of solute divided by volume of solution. Okay, fine. So, moving to the next question. Okay, see, now we have the next question. Please see the leaderboard first, then we'll move to the next. Dhruv RNR 9 is leading as of now. Okay, fine. So, please see the question. Question is the choose the incorrect statement about true solution. Incorrect statement about true solution. Its component cannot be separated by filtration. It's opaque and unstable. Its particles cannot be seen by naked eye. It does not show Tyndall effect. Choose the incorrect statement. Okay, very easy question, but I think true solution. True solution, what all the filtration, opaque, thanks. Okay, fine. So the answer for this is 39 students have done this right. You know, true solution is, you know, it's a transparent, first of all. So do you want me to discuss this question? See? Okay, fine. No? Sure? Okay, I want to tell you true solution. Okay, what was the answer then? What was the answer which was wrong? True solution does not show Tyndall effect. True solution does not show Tyndall effect. And solutions are seen by naked eye. You can't see the solution by naked eye. Even you can't see using microscope also for the true solution. Understood? Any doubt? Okay. If anyone has any doubt, please ask. Okay, fine. Moving to the next question. First, we'll see the leaderboard. Okay, Prateek Tejaswi, RNR 9, is still leading. Oh, good. 1 minute, student. Okay, fine. Moving to the next question. Be ready for that. Barium sulfate dispersed in water used in diagnostic X-ray is a barium sulfate dispersed in water used diagnostic X-ray is a colloid, solution, suspension and cone. Think you need to use your brain in this question, I'm telling you. If you have not heard about this question, it doesn't matter. You have to use your brain and answer this question. Most of you are thinking we have not heard about this, so what to do? But if you think about barium sulfate, you can easily answer this question. Monisha, you have, but you have to accept this and it's time's up. And the answer is, it is suspension. Okay, students, I want to ask you one thing. Barium sulfate is soluble in water or not? Just tell me one thing. Is barium sulfate soluble in water? Is barium sulfate soluble in water?
No, sir.
No, my dear students. Barium sulfate is not soluble in water. If barium sulfate is not soluble, you put into water, it will settle down. And it will form suspension. Okay. It depends on question to question. You have to see the time, Pratham. Because this question is... For this question, I said 45 seconds. For some questions, I have said 120 seconds and for some 90 seconds. Okay, so based on question to question, you are getting time. Any doubt in this question?
Sir, can you show me?
Leaderboard, I'll show you. First, tell me any doubt. No doubts? Okay, fine. Okay, Prateek is still leading. Fastest also. Very good, Prateek. Moving to the next question. Please read the question care properly and then answer. How many liters of 15% mass by volume sugar solution would it take to get 75% of sugar? How many liters of 15% mass by volume sugar solution would it take to get 75 gram of sugar? A, B, C, D is corresponding, like one is equivalent to A, two is equivalent to B, three C, four D. How many liters? No, you don't know, but you have to use, that's why I told you in last question, I told you somewhere you are going to use this formula. Percentage mass by volume, what I said, use that percentage mass by volume for sugar solution and 75 grams of sugar you have. Students, we still have 30 seconds. Okay, the question is good. That's why it took long. Don't worry, Nishant. Okay, how many liters of 15 gram percent mass by volume sugar solution? 75 gram sugar. Solute mass is given to you, 75 gram. Just you need to find the... Okay, fine. Oh, 35 students have answered it right. But I think there is a need of explaining this question. I can't skip this question. I think it's question number 10. Yes? Question number 10. Just give me 1 second, I'll explain this, then we'll move to the next question. Okay. See, very easy question. Just remember the percentage weight by volume. What is the percentage weight by volume? I told you in my class also, those who are not in my class, percentage weight by weight is weight of solute. Weight of solute. Okay, I'll do one thing so that you can. Weight of solute divided by, I'll tell you why I'm changing color also here, divided by weight of solution. Weight of solution. Now, you know why I've written weight of solute? This red thing will remain common no matter whatever the concentration terms you want. Like if you have percentage weight by volume. So what you're going to write? Weight of solute remain as it is here. Weight of solute divided by volume of solution. Because it is percentage weight by volume. Volume of solution. This is percentage weight by volume. If you have percentage volume by volume, what is the formula? What is the formula percentage volume by volume? Okay, into 100. Don't forget to write into 100. Sorry, my dear. Into 100. Yes. Percentage volume by volume. Weight. Volume of solution. Volume of solute. Divided by volume of solution. Okay. This is the common formula which you can apply anywhere. Into 100. Okay. Now. Now see what, how to do this question. Percentage given to you. 15. So mass of solute is also given to you. Mass of solute is given to you. Divided by volume of solution. Volume of solution. You don't know. So what mass of solute? It is 15%. Okay, into 100 also you need to do. So what I can write? 15 equals to 75 gram. Divide by volume into 100. What is the volume then? Volume is come. Volume of solution you are going to get. Why you people made this wrong? I have no idea. Okay, it is 0.5 liter, because the answer will be in ml. Answer will be in ml. You need to convert it into meter, liter. Any doubt? Yes, you are going to get 500 ml. Okay, fine. Any doubts? Please put NN if you have no doubt. Okay, fine. Coming to the next question. Okay. First, we'll see the leaderboard. Why, Prateek, why you made mistake in this question? I have no idea. The question was very easy and I explained many times in class.
I got right.
Okay, you have written I wrong. I don't know why you have written. Okay, read the question carefully. White gold is used in jewelry and contains two elements, gold and palladium. Very less reactive. Both are very less reactive. That's why you can use them in jewelry. A jeweler has two different samples. You know,
so this is very honest. Yes.
Jeweler has two different samples that are both identical in appearance and have a uniform composition throughout. What can be said about the samples? What can be said about the samples? They are homogeneous mixture and can be classified as metallic alloy. Okay, I think most of you have answered also. 43. The material are homogeneous mixture and can be classified by their components. The samples have variable composition and reclassify as metallic solution. And D, the samples are heterogeneous mixture that can be separated using magnetic properties. Yes, I am sharing the link of test just after this class. Just after this class. Okay. Okay, answer for this question is A. Most of you have answered it right. Very good, students. So how to answer this question? Very easy. I think most of you got it right only, but still few of them have done it wrong. For them, okay, so 1 minute. Okay, white, there are two metals, gold, and two metals are given to you. One is the gold and one is the palladium. Okay, a jeweler has two different samples. Now, uniform composition throughout. What can be said about this? They are homogeneous mixtures. Homogeneous mixture, I told you, and can be classified as metallic alloys. That is the correct answer. Any doubt? No? Okay, fine. So coming to the next question, see, and the metallic is a heterogeneous mixture, it's not heterogeneous mixture. Okay, this I explained in class. Though alloys are always a homogeneous mixture, alloys are actually exception. Alloys are a homogeneous mixture. Yes, I told you it is an exception. You can't separate. Can you separate alloys? Can you separate alloys? Can you separate alloys? Yes, and fixed. Can you separate alloys? I will share the link for the test. Don't worry. This is no, just sir. For. Okay, fastest was the Prateek. Okay, moving to the next question. Be ready for that. Solubility is good separation technique for what? Very, very important question. I want to explain one small topic with help of this question. That's why I gave this. Solubility is good separation technique for what thing? Pure metals, noble gases, different salts, metallic alloys. Okay, I'm telling you, you think, you have to think. Solubility. Solubility is a good technique for what? You have to think. It's not like you will. Okay, fine. And it's time's up. Okay, fine. Most of you have given the right answer. Now I want to tell you very important thing. Very, very important thing. What is that important thing? That solubility questions. You know, I want to give you one example. Let's say, just give me 1 second. Okay, see, if there are two salts, you have the option to use the solubility. One is soluble, another is not. How you go like, how you decide which is soluble? Okay, 1 minute. See. Okay. This is the question. You know, I want to explain you one thing in this. What is that? Whenever you have a solubility related question, you need to think like that. Okay, let's say you have two things. Barium sulfate and AgCl, let's say. Okay, now what should I do? What should I add so that I can separate these salts? How can I separate these salts? Any idea? Any idea? Both are precipitate. How could I separate it? Any idea? So what I do? That's what I want. Crystallization. Okay, fine. But what I want to say, let's say, okay, these are both insoluble salts, but if you want to separate them, what you can do, if I add, let's say if I add calcium sulfate in that, if I want to separate barium and aluminium, what will happen? If, okay, just give me 1 second, and I'll give you one more example. Let's say, this is barium sulfate is insoluble, AgCl is insoluble, but you know, calcium chloride is soluble and calcium sulfate is insoluble. Calcium sulfate is insoluble. Okay, these things you need to remember. Calcium sulfate is insoluble and calcium chloride is soluble. So what you do, you add something which can dissolve this AgCl. Okay, so what I want to tell, like if you put CaCl2 in this, your AgCl will get dissolved. Okay, let's say any calcium salt like I am taking calcium, which soluble salt can I take now? Let's say calcium salts of, let's say any salt which having a calcium plus 2 ion. What will happen? Calcium will form the, calcium plus 2 is there? Yes. Now it will dissolve the AgCl. Why? Because calcium will react with Cl minus to form a CaCl2. CaCl2, it will be soluble. And but Ca will not dissolve in sulfate. In SO4, Ca is not soluble. That's why what you are going to get? You are going to get a precipitate. A very good example. One more example is there. Let's say you have an aluminium chloride. You have aluminium chloride. And there is one more thing, that is zinc chloride. If you have these two salts, how to separate them? You know what you need to do? You put NaOH in both of them. If you put NaOH, both are soluble. If this is a salt A, this is salt B, A and B are soluble. A and B are soluble. Okay, first they will, okay, I can write A and B, AlCl3 and ZnCl2, both get dissolved. What are the compounds formed? AlOH whole thrice and ZnOH whole twice. Okay, so now what we can write, A and B both are insoluble. Both are insoluble. Now there is a very important point. If you put NH4OH, ammonia, one is soluble means Zn is, this will get dissolved. Zinc hydroxide will get dissolved. So zinc hydroxide get dissolved, but no change in aluminum hydroxide. If you put ammonia here, no change. So what I want to tell, whenever there are two salts, you have an option to use the different type of solution. Okay, so these, why it is getting dissolved? Because these two salts are amphoteric in nature. Write the word amphoteric. Amphoteric in nature. You may ask, sir, what all salts are amphoteric? In one class I told, just you can remember, tin, okay, BeCr. Okay, you can, for you, okay. It says remember like this, Suno Janabe Ali, Bekar, BeCr, Bekar Gaye, Prabhat, Punjabi song. Okay, so you can remember like this, Suno Janabe Ali, Bekar Gaye, Prabhat, Punjabi song. So these are all the amphoteric metals, or these are all forming amphoteric oxides. Amphoteric oxides. Always remember tin, Pb, Al, BeCr, GaPb, and there is zinc, Al and Pb is important for you. For you to learn, there are many, in 11th you will need this, but zinc, aluminum and lead, you need to remember it now. It is very, very important. Suno Janabe Ali, Bekar Gaye, Prabhat, Punjabi song. But I think you know that I am singing good, yes? So it is just I made it. Okay, fine. Moving, any doubt in that? Any doubt in that question?
No, sir.
Okay. Moving to the next question. Be ready for that. Okay, so Pratik is still leading. Good, Pratik. Then Jagrav, HSR. Very good, Jagrav. I think Jagrav, in the last centimeter, I think you won that. You got the first position, if I remember it correct. You have prepared four different mixer in water using charcoal powder, chalk powder, slaked lime and detergent powder. Please read the question carefully. If you filter these mixtures through a filter paper, there will be no residue left after filtration in case of charcoal powder, chalk powder, slaked lime, detergent powder. Very, very important question.
I don't know.
Slaked lime. Why these people don't know? Okay, for your help, I can tell you. Slaked lime is nothing but CaOH whole twice. CaOH whole twice is slaked lime. CaOH whole twice. CaOH whole twice. Which of them will pass through the filter paper? Okay, you have 20 seconds left. Which of them is going to pass? Charcoal powder, chalk powder, slaked lime and detergent powder. Last 7 seconds. No residue left means should pass through the filter paper, and I think most of you have done it wrong. You know, there is very important point. Most of you think like that, but you know there is a very important point. That's why I've added this question. Many of you have this misconception that slaked lime, CaOH whole twice, is soluble in water. That's why you have written it will pass through the filter paper. But the fact is, calcium hydroxide is insoluble or slightly soluble in water. Calcium hydroxide is slightly soluble in water. Slightly soluble in water. Slightly soluble in water. That's why it will not pass. You will get the precipitate there. Okay? What all solubles? Calcium sulfate, insoluble. Calcium hydroxide. All the hydroxide other than the group 1 atom, group 1 metal, generally all hydroxides are insoluble. What are the group 1 metal? These are the group 1 metal in the periodic table. These, other than these metals, all hydroxides are insoluble. Mostly. Okay, and one more is that ammonium hydroxide. All these hydroxides are soluble. Rest all are insoluble. Okay, how to remember this? I have a hint trick for this to remember. It is in Hindi. Halina ki rab se paryar, FR is the last atom, but it is a radioactive. That's why we don't study that. Okay, Halina ki rab se paryar. All these are group 1 atoms. Okay, this is a trick. Halina ki rab se paryar. Okay, these are all group 1 atoms. Then later in periodic table I will tell you more tricks. Not now. Moving to the next question. First we'll see the leaderboard. Okay. Jagra, okay, fine. Now see, Pratik is still leading, fine, and Vihan is the fastest. Very good, Vihan. There is one more question for you, and this is the last question. So listen, okay, look at your phone. Okay, wait. Wait, students.
So what's the answer?
I'll tell you the answer, wait.
So there's no question.
Can you show us the thing on the slide? Sir, show us the question on the slide, we'll answer.
Okay, fine. I'll show in the slide. Wait. You can answer, yes. I'll show in the slide. Okay,
so
fine.
So time is getting over.
Okay, then answer it at D. Answer it D. Answer it D.
D or B?
D for dog, Delhi.
Okay.
So some of us already answered wrong.
Okay, fine. We'll see the question, then we'll decide. Okay, see, the question is this.
Sir, can you repeat this question?
Okay, see, this is the question. When light is passed through the sample...
No, it's okay, leave it.
When the light is passed through the sample A and B in a light room, what the effect observed are as shown in the figure. Which one of the following pairs is a correct description of both the samples? Can you tell me what is that? Here the light is passing, you know, light is passing, but it is not scattering. Then what is the possibility of first if it is not scattering? It does not scatter means light is passing but does not scatter. What does this mean?
It is solution.
Okay, now why light is visible in a path of light? See, visible path of light is there. So there are two possibilities. What two possibilities? It may be suspension. It may be suspension. It may be colloid. Any of these are the possibilities. Now they have given the option gel. Gel is a colloid. So not this is not an answer. Gel is a colloid. Okay. Now A solution and B solution. A and B both are solution. No, no. This is also not correct. Now, A gel and B suspension. Is A gel and B suspension? A is not gel because gel is nothing but is a colloid. Gel is nothing but colloid. A solution, B gel, C gel. Okay, C we can ignore, but A solution and B gel. That seems the correct answer. A is the solution and gel is there means it is a colloid. Understood? Any doubt? Please ask if anyone has any doubt. Okay, fine. So, okay, fine. Moving to the next, I'll explain you. I'll show you the result. Okay, fine. So you could have waited for this. So now answer for the leaderboard. Vihan, IPR, YPR 9. Who is leading in this quiz?
Jagra
was the fastest. Oh, Pratik Tejasvi RNR 9 got this. Congratulations, Pratik. Congratulations. Okay, Jagra, no problem. Jagra, you are second. It's a very good fight and very good, Jagra. Both of you. Pardon? What you are saying? Okay, Jagrav said he got in 20 seconds, but I got in 4, he has got. Okay, fine, fine. So it's good, congratulations students. Okay, and I think you must have learned something about the concentration terms. That is a very important part. Okay, so any doubt you have, please ask. Any doubt? Okay, if anyone has any doubt, please ask. Okay, fine. So, thank you, students.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, all of you.
Thank you, sir. Bye.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, thank you, students. Okay, thank you, Nishant. I know that. Okay, but still it's all or for all it's same, yes. Bye. Okay, I'm sharing that folder that link with you in INR 9. Thank you, students.